Okay, today we'll be continuing with the work examples or work problems on speed. So for this part of the problems, you are advised to use diagrams, simple diagrams to illustrate the question so that you have a better understanding of what's going on. Okay, so for the first example, we'll be discussing catching up. Okay, when one person catches up to the other, usually we use red to solve the question. Okay, so for this question, John lives in town D. Well, Jenny lives in town E. So let's start with John first. This is town E, town D. Okay, they said in the next sentence that one day both of them decided to walk to town F at 8 a.m. and the walking route is such that you need to reach town E first before reaching town F. So E must be located in between town D and town F, and this is where Jenny will start her journey. So both of them will start at walking at 8 a.m. and their speeds are given later on. Okay, the next sentence mentions that town D is located 2.76 kilometers away from E. So the distance between town D and town E is given. So that is actually 2.76 kilometers. Okay, as for their speeds, John's average speed is 90 meters per minute. Whereas Jenny's is 50 meters per minute. Okay, so what they want us to find next is, what time will will John catch up to Jenny? Because John is behind. At some point of time, they will catch up to each other. Okay, so let's start with the first step. First thing you want to do is find the difference in their speed first. So take the larger one, 90 minus 50. And you will get 40 meters per minute. Okay, what this 40 meters per minute means is every 1 minute, John is catching up to Jenny by 40 meters. Okay, so the second step we'll be using red. So every 40 meters, it will take 1 minute. Right? So John will catch up to Jenny by 40 meters every 1 minute. So initially, their total gap is 2.76 kilometers. Okay, we shall go back here. 2.76 kilometers in meters is supposed to be 2.76 times 1,000, which gives us 2760 meters. Okay, I did that because we are going to solve the question in meters, because just now we are doing 40 meters here. So 2760 meters will take us. 2760 divided by 40 times 1 minute, and it will give us a total of 69 minutes. So what this means is to close up the gap that they were far away between just now. At the start, B and E was 2.76 kilometers apart. So in order to close the gap, it will need John to take 69 minutes to do that. And 69 minutes can be converted into 1 hour, 9 minutes. Okay, so now that we know how long John will take to catch up to Jenny, we can begin answering the question. So what time will they meet when John catches up to Jenny? Their starting time was 8 a.m. just now. So the time they meet will be 8 a.m. plus 1 hour, 9 minutes later. So 0109. So the time they meet will be at 9:09 a.m. So this is the time they meet. Okay, so that covers the first problem. on catching up. Okay, we will move on to the second problem. Okay, this time around, in the second problem, you still have two people, but they are moving in opposite directions. Okay, so example number two, you have a motorcycle leaving town X and moving towards town Y. So the motorcycle is heading towards town Y. Okay, the distance was given also. Distance was 675 kilometers. Okay, the speed of the motorcyclist is 100 kilometers per hour. Okay, this is a motorcycle. As for later on, there's another vehicle. A car. Okay, a car left town Y moving towards town X. So the car is moving in the opposite direction. And the speed of the car is not directly given, but it's mentioned that the speed of the car is 4/5 of the motorcycle. So first thing we want to find is try to find the speed of the car first. Okay, so the first step. So continue here with the speed of car. Speed of car will be 100 times 4/5, and this will give us 80 kilometers per hour. Okay, so we can label our diagram here with the car's speed. All right, so the second thing we do is try to find out in 1 hour how much distance in total did the car and the motorcycle cover. So in 1 hour, total distance equals 100 plus 80. Because in 1 hour, the motorcycle traveled 100 kilometers. That's why it's 100 kilometers per hour. As for car, it's every 1 hour, 80 kilometers will be covered. So total distance covered is 180 kilometers every 1 hour. Initially, the gap between them is 675 kilometers. So next, we will try to find how much time they need in order to catch up or meet each other in the center. So the time taken to cover 675 kilometers will be the distance, 675, divided by 180 kilometers that they cover every 1 hour. You can think of that as the speed, combined speed. So the total time taken will be 3¾ hours. So what the question was asking was, how far away from town X did they meet? So since they are mentioning from town X, you should use the motorcycle's speed. So use the motorcycle speed, 100. You multiply the time taken to catch up to each other, and you will get the distance from town X. So that will be 375 kilometers. Okay, so that will be the second example. Right, so let's move on to the third question. All right, so in the third example, this time around there's two persons again, but they are traveling in opposite directions away from each other. The second example, they were moving towards each other. So this is a bit different. Okay, so you have two persons now, Xiaoling and Miling, both started driving from the same place, but in the opposite directions along a straight road. So initially, this is how the diagram looks like. Miling and Xiaoling. Okay, so Xiaoling, I'll call it XL. mailing will be ML. Okay, so they are moving away from each other. Then what happens is, after 3 hours, they were 380 kilometers apart. We will come back to that part later. Xiao Ling's average speed, this is mentioned in the next sentence, is given to be 90 kilometers per hour. So we will label here 90 kilometers per hour for Mei Ling. For Xiao Ling, we don't know yet. Xiao Ling is 90 kilometers per hour. For Mei Ling, we don't know yet. Right. So now we will try to draw the diagram again. After 3 hours, how does it look like? So after 3 hours, they will develop a gap between them. And this gap happens to be 380 kilometers. Okay, their speed is still the same. Xiao Ling, Mei Ling. Xiao Ling is 90 kilometers per hour. And Mei Ling's is still unknown. Okay, so now we will begin finding what the question wants us to do, which is to find Mei Ling's speed. Okay, so first thing we should do is work out how much distance Xiao Ling covered in 3 hours. So by the way, this diagram is after 3 hours. Distance traveled by Xiao Ling in 3 hours will be 90, the speed, times 3 hours, the time taken. So total she traveled 270 kilometers. Because the gap between them was given, 380 kilometers was what the distance between them was after 3 hours. If you were to subtract 380 with 270, you will get the distance traveled by Mei Ling in 3 hours. So let's take 380, the total distance between them, minus 270, which was the distance covered by Xiao Ling, and you will get 110. Okay, since you know the distance that Xiao Ling, Mei Ling traveled, you should be able to find her speed. So Mei Ling's speed will be the distance traveled, which is 110, divided by her time taken. This is also 3 hours, just like Xiao Ling previously. And you should get 36 2/3 kilometers per hour. That's her speed. Okay, so with that, we will end the video for all the examples for this topic.